In this video, you will learn how to repeat the same text in a Word document in multiple places. The sample document contains the customer name in multiple spots, and we're going to change the document so that we only have to insert the customer name in the first location, and that entry will then auto-update all the other locations. For that, we select the customer name, go to the Insert tab, and click on Bookmark. Here, we now write down a bookmark name, and note that if you want to use multiple words for your bookmark, you will have to use a dash or an underscore character between the words, otherwise the Add button will be grayed out. Also, if you're creating multiple bookmarks, make sure that your bookmark name is unique so that you don't overwrite an existing bookmark. Once we found a suitable name, we click on Add, and with that, the bookmark is set. Now we go to the other locations in our document where the customer name occurs. Here we delete the customer name, then we again go to the Insert tab and we click on Cross-Reference. Then we set the Reference Type dropdown to Bookmark and the Insert Reference To dropdown to Bookmark Text. Afterwards, we select the previously created bookmark from the list below and confirm everything with a click on Insert. And we repeat that process for all the other occurrences of our keyword. Note that when you want to edit your bookmarks, you have to be super careful. To explain why, we are going to make the bookmarks visible. For that, we go to File, Options, Advanced, and in the Show Document Content section, we check the box which says Show Bookmarks and confirm everything with OK. You can now see that a bookmark is visualized by these rectangular brackets. If we place our cursor at the end of the word customer and then delete some characters and add new characters, then the newly added characters are outside of the bookmark. So when we update all the cross-references in our document by quickly going to File, Print, and then back again, the newly added characters are missing in the cross-references. Therefore, we always need to make sure that we edit a bookmark from the inside. So we place the cursor somewhere inside the bookmark, write in the new word, and then we delete all the old characters around that new word. If we now update the whole document again by going to File, Print, and then back again, you can see that everything worked out as it should. To make all of this a lot more efficient and user-friendly, I'm gonna share a secret trick with you. First of all, we delete the bookmark, then we go to the Developer tab and insert a rich text content control. And by the way, if you're not seeing the Developer tab, it might be the case that you have to activate it in the options. Once the field is inserted, we activate the design mode, and then we click on this blue ribbon next to the text so that all of the text gets selected. Now we change the text color to red, and we insert a custom placeholder text. Afterwards, we deactivate the design mode again. The red color is only there to highlight the field so that you immediately realize that you still have to fill in some content into this field. Once you start filling in content, the color will change to the default color of the paragraph again. After we finished designing the field, we click into it so that the field border shows up, and on the left, we click on the tab with the three dots to make sure that the full field is selected. And from here on, we proceed with all the steps again that we learned in the first minute of the video. Since the bookmark now covers the whole fillable field, we can edit the field in any way we want, and the bookmark brackets will still stay nicely around the field. So now you not only know how to insert a bookmark, but you also know how to insert a salient fillable field that makes the usage of the bookmark 10 times more efficient and user-friendly. If this video helped you, then please support this free knowledge by hitting the subscribe and the like button. Thanks a lot, and I see you in the next one.